Well, Dream, that was a big-time moment, and it really added a punctuation point, or mark, if you will, to a big weekend for WCW. We all saw what happened on the air. The Scorpion death drop once, but after he went off the air, he did it again, stuffed him in the hole, and that was a moment we, and I'm sure Eric Bischoff, will never forget.
Yeah, just when you might have thought at home that he made a mistake, he wanted to let you know that was no mistake about what he was doing when he dropped him the second time as we went off the air and stuffed him in the hole.
You know, I've seen him put the Scorpion death drop on a man one time, but never before twice.
Exactly. But he did it.
And
we showed it to him.
Yes, we did.
Exclusively.
Exclusively.
We appreciate if you bunch of Maryland hillbillies would stand up.
When are we going to shut this guy up?
Well, it's a great song, and it's a moving piece, but they don't do it real well.
No, they don't. They wrestle much better than they
yes,
sing.
Yes, they do.
It is our main event. Still to come, fans, we will hear from DDP, Diamond Dallas Page, as we prepare for Page Savage Part 2. No disqualification. And as we prepare for that, we're going to dip out of this to show you this. That WCW Monday Nitro is live. It's original starting time, 7:55 p.m., only on TNT. It returns this Monday, Memorial Day, for 2 hours live. And here they come, Dream, Rick, and Scott, the Steiner brothers.
It's a good matchup for the mothership here on Saturday night, right here on the Superstation. Steiner brothers, they own a little bit of a roll. And I tell you, the French Canadians have yet to really get off the mark. Victory here on the way to the pay window would really drive them towards that world tag team title.
Rick and Scott, the Steiner brothers, realize that they are due the world tag team title shot. But through all his maneuverings before he was in, or while he was in power, before he was dropped by Sting, what did Eric Bischoff do to prevent the Steiners from getting another title shot? We'll find out when we come back. We are back, and it is time for the main event between the Steiners and the amazing French Canadians. And, you know, I asked the question, Dream, are the Steiners, through some sort of contract maneuvering that Eric Bischoff has done that we can't get out of, have the Steiners been blackballed? I mean,
you know, you kind of look at it in a situation where they are the world's tag team titles, but they aren't. Stipulations were handed down, belts stripped of them, and you know, so much power that Eric Bischoff and the NWO and Hollywood Hulk Hogan has. And now then, as you said, maybe, well, we use the word blackball, but it looks like it in plain layman English, that might be what's happening. But they need to continue to win, because the tide will sooner or later turn for them in that world title shot.
Certainly, now under the auspices of James J. Dillon, things have been changing, including, as we talked about earlier, the reinstatement of Nick Patrick, who did the right thing at Slamboree the other night, but is still on probation. But we'll be seeing Nick Patrick in the weeks to come here.
Well, he did the one right thing. Did that counteract all the bad things he done? I don't know. It's hard for me to accept Nick Patrick back in the fold. And a great referee that he was. Can he be that again?
That's the question. That's why the probationary period as deemed by the WCW Executive Committee. Right now, we are showing you Scott Steiner at his best. When he can hook you and when he can send you over the top with those variety of suplexes that he uses, you're seeing Scott Steiner at his very best.
Well, he possesses power. He's a great mat technician, and he seems to keep his head just a little bit, even though he is driven by excitement than his brother does. Because we're getting ready to see his brother now. You talk about the baddest dog in the pound. Now, I'll show you what I mean by keeping his head and just going crazy. See, this is just nuts. This is going crazy. The French Canadians, they understand the importance of a victory here also. They want to get to the pay window because their time is a running out as far as moving themselves up the ladder in the World Tag Team title picture.
The Steiners always employ the same strategy. And that strategy is they'll start with Scott to try to set the tone, and then they'll bring in Rick Steiner, who really brings the pace up a notch. And what has happened here is that Rougeau, knowing this, is trying to slow things down with Rick.
Well, he did for a minute, but yep. He got kicked right back.
Yep.
Yeah, he did just for a minute. You're right. He was trying to use some strategy, but It didn't work.
You can't confuse a man who is already confused. Oh. Picked up and down he goes.
Yeah, that was an awkward move right there. Could have hurt him real bad. Coming in, got him again. Oh. Clothesline. These guys really, really compliment each other. I'm talking about the dog, Rick Steiner. Scott Steiner, my boys. Getting down here on Saturday Night, the Mothership. Tony Savage, page two. Big fight coming up this summer at the Great American Bash. And we're going to be talking. Well, he's going to be talking to us. Ain't nobody that's going to be interviewing him.
Diamond Dallas Page is here.
Right after this matchup right here.
He wants time on his own. And you really brought up a good point earlier. No one helped him on the way up.
Yeah.
He wants no one to hold the microphone for him.
That's good.
And DDP really goes into the match of his career, of his life, coming up at the Great American Bash.
You can almost say that with everything that has happened to him up to this point, because he has come from that underdog role of really making a nice move, making a name for himself. But now he's in a position where he either got to do it or get off the pot. You know what I mean?
I know.
He needs to go ahead and let's get on with this thing, because the Macho Man will not give up the throne easily.
On either side of the ring, the Steiners are in command.
They were pounding.
But how about the Canadians? Oh! Canadians had a pretty good notion that time, but wrong guys.
Yeah, that's as good as you're going to call it. A good notion, but the wrong people come out on top of this thing. This is becoming a good matchup here. What a 2 hours we've had right here on Saturday Night. Great American Bash coming up. Nitro back at its regular time, coming up live from Nashville, Tennessee, coming up Monday. Let me tell you, boys, it's going to be big. L.A., Detroit, you know, out there. I mean, everything. I mean, it's just happening here. Raising the roof at WCW.
And there you see the double team.
Yeah.
This is what they've been
looking for. That wasn't clubbing there, because they only were using two hands. They didn't have full fists. No clubbing on the hands of the French Canadian.
In, up.
Oh,
wow, what elevation that time.
Set him up, see if they can put him away.
Also, fans, very quickly, WCW coming to Athens, Ohio, Dayton, Ohio, and Buffalo, New York. We'll be in Dayton on June 2nd, a week from Monday, with WCW Monday Nitro at the Hera Arena.
Is this still cold in the summer in Buffalo?
I'm sure it is.
Oh, I imagine. Look at this.
Double team. Like it's cold in Saginaw, Michigan, and in Canada. Outside goes Rick Steiner, and there is Colonel Parker.
That's the problem you run in when you go outside and you got to manage somebody as devious as Colonel Parker. They're already putting the boots to him, been double-teaming him really good. I tell you, Steiner's now in a bad way in this matchup here on Saturday night.
Fans, as we said, so many questions pending in WCW. Where was Piper? We had answered that question. Shooting a brand new movie he'll be starring in. Who will be showing up on June 30th? Hopefully a lot of questions will be answered this Monday live on Nitro.
Oh!
Great double team by the Canadians. And a cover, one, two, and they almost got a win.
Well, Tony, you answered the question on where he was. I asked the question about priorities at WCW and what's going on. Never been a member of WCW. I'm talking about Piper. Picks a good fight. Fights a good fight. Electricity abounds when he's around. But right now, the Nature Boy Ric Flair, mud hole being stomped in him. We understand the situation with the Horseman really not meshing right now, because Benoit's strung out thinking about Kevin Sullivan. So I guarantee you, questions need to be answered. But most of all, the thing with Sting, the NWO, I guarantee you, Luger, when will he get his title shot? Speculation running crazy.
We'll see Luger live this Monday on Nitro.
Maybe he'll tell us.
Maybe he will. There is a lariat out of desperation that time. Rick could not make the tag to Scott. And that gave now Jacques Rougeau the chance for this double team maneuver.
And they've been doing it well, too, man.
Oh!
That backfired.
Up until that point, they had been.
And okay, Tony, who is Sonny Bono bringing Monday night? Come on.
We don't know. The only way to find out is to tune in live.
Man, I thought I'd catch you off guard there, because you were rolling. When you just start spitting out names, you can get one of them out of you. Got him slammed. Good move. Well, Scott Steiner come in fresh.
Oh, boy. Steiner is ruling the ring now. Taking care of both men. Rick just to his feet, right at your screen. Now, who's the legal Canadian here? Doesn't matter to Scott Steiner at all.
Dumps him outside. Rougeau.
It's apparently
being
John
picked
Rougeau.
Up.
Yes,
oh,
sir.
Baby, you can call it now. Turn the lights out. If he nails this thing, it's over, Tony.
Oh, no.
Cut him off.
And there you see Parker coming into play, because that was going to be it for Jacques Rougeau. Rick Steiner out. Scott being double-teamed. They're going to try their pile driver, maybe. Oh, boy. Parker's laying on the outside.
He took a swing with that flagpole, but it missed. That's Connage going on in the ring right here. Look at this now. Going for a victory. Upset-minded French Canadians.
Rick Steiner's waiting on him. Rick Steiner. Oh, he powerbombed him out of that. And a cover by Scott. One,
that was
two,
that was
three.
Amazing.
Steiner takes the victory on the way to the pay window Saturday night.
You're not going to find a bigger match than Paige Savage 2 at the Great American Bash. Diamond Dallas Page has something he wants to say. Let's go to him right now.